Hi, my name is Richard Vogg, and I'm happy to be here and talk about how I became a data composer. This ability of composing data or creating data from scratch has been increasingly helpful for me at my last job. I was working for a data analytics company in Chile for the last years, and the client that we were supporting with analytics was one of the largest banks in the United States. Similar to a music composer, who assembles musical notes and chords into melodies and songs, I started to play around with datasets. And using R, it is very easy to get started. It is fun to get started, as many of you might also have experienced. So, for example, it is very easy to create 1,000 random normally distributed variables, and we can also easily create variables from other distributions, like the exponential distribution, or we can create categorical variables by using the sample function. We can combine all those variables in a data frame, and then we have our first, in this case, nonsense dataset ready. And then we can go and take a look at the data, and we can check if what we composed is actually what we wanted to compose, if it makes sense. So I started to create small melodies, small data melodies, in the beginning because it was fun, and later because it was useful. I used this skill in the business world to improve the communication with non-technical business partners. So I created small and easy data sets and visualizations about topics that the business partners felt comfortable with, and used them to explain concepts, explain methods, and in general to create a common ground for discussion and for questions. When you compose a song for your band, it is not enough to have a beautiful melody for each one of the instruments, but you also want them to sound good together. So in data words, we do not only want independent variables, but we also want them to make some sort of sense together. And I trained that skill and used it a lot because we were working with sensitive data, so you could not just send data to someone else with a question, but because not everyone had the same level of access to the data. And instead, I quickly assembled a suitable data set for each occasion and was able to ask questions but also to give advice without having to see the real data or having to touch the real data. Another application emerged when we had more and more agile projects, so we had this aim of having a working deliverable in each iteration, and this was sometimes hard to reach because we had to wait a lot of time for the data, so we had to talk to the data owner, sometimes request accesses, we had to bring the data into the right format. And by using a composed data set that looked like the expected final data set, we could already start to work on the output, on the report, and while we were still waiting for the real data. And in the end, we simply replaced that composed data set with the real data set and improved the whole process a lot. When you want to write a symphony, you're not just aligning a few instruments, but you have actually blocks or groups of instruments that have to sound good together. And in data words, that could be a database where you have several tables that are all connected with each other. And it is not easy to create a complete database from scratch, but we still did it to improve our internal courses. So we wanted to make those courses closer to what we actually work with. And we created a client table, transaction table, account tables, and combined all of them. And made this whole database available to everyone in the company, to the internal courses, and also for small prototypes and projects. All this was about why data composition is important. Now, how to compose with R. There are, of course, the distributions. I already showed in the beginning how easy it is to work with the distributions. And there are also a lot of functions that can help you to correlate your simulated data to create those connections between the variables. There are functions that help you to create the relations between tables. And of course, there are a lot of packages out there that just wait to be explored that can support you on your data composition process. And as I just have a few seconds left, I wrote a blog post for each one of those 4 points. You can, I invite you to visit my blog, and there are a lot more details about those topics, and I hope they might be helpful for you to become a data composer too. Thank you very much for your attention.